How good is it waking up to a beautiful day on Lake Jindabyne, then having a nice breakfast at the hotel, going on the snowy river way through Dalgetty to Bombala, and then the first 20 kilometres of Bonang Road before turning on to McKillops Road, the first bit of gravel for the day. Rather than do the standard route to Omeo, such as on the highway, we're going to do the scenic route, which is going to involve mostly gravel for the day. On Bonang Road, there is an earlier turn off, which will also get you to McKillop's Bridge, and it makes it a bit of a shorter trip, but we did want to do a few of the twisties on Bonang before we made the turn off and did the way along McKillop's Road instead. This eastern side of McKillop's Road is very easy riding. It's pretty smooth gravel, and we've got a nice blue sky, sunny day to enjoy. The first town you pass is probably the only town we pass is a place called Tubbert, which actually gets its portion of the road sealed as you ride through it. Now McKillop's Road actually tracks along the Deddick River following its trail, and a little bit past Tubbert you get to the Ambyne Suspension Bridge. Now the Ambyne Suspension Bridge was built in 1935 so that farm trucks could cross the Deddick River. Even though it was restored in 2005, I'd have to say that a few of those timber panels didn't feel too secure. And those old farm trucks would have been a lot narrower than today's trucks because the bridge isn't that wide to cross. The surface continues on to be pretty easy going, but the scenery changes as well. And it does look quite nice when we get that mountainous cut in on the side of the road. There was a noticeable decline as we started winding our way down towards the river, ready to cross the McKillop's Bridge. The McKillop's Bridge, which spans 255 metres across the snowy river, isn't just an amazing sight, it's an extraordinary engineering feat created in the early 1930s. It's also the only bridge that crosses the Snowy River for a very long way. Once crossing the bridge, heading southwest, the road follows the Snowy River for some way, and it certainly gets more narrow and with a cliff face on each side. By now the temperature had heated up to 32 degrees, so we were quite warm. As you move away from the river and start the climb, the road is also narrower, and it reminds me a little bit more of Snowy River Road. You could see the road was mostly in pretty good condition and has been recently graded, but it's pretty narrow, so you don't really want a car to be coming the other way, especially on one of these blind bends. And you don't want to be looking too much at the scenery either, because it is rather stunning. A little further on McKillop's Road is a turn off Little River Gorge track, and that takes you to the deepest gorge in Victoria, which is about a 500 metre walk from the car park down to the Little River Gorge, which is definitely worth the walk down. but does require a little bit of fitness to get back up, because heading back, it's basically uphill all the way. We thought that the walk to see the little river gorge was certainly worth it. The last 5 or 6 kilometres of McKillops Road is sealed, and this will take us to the junction where you can make a left to go to Buchan on Jellintippy Road, or turn right on Snowy River Road, which will take you through to Jindabyne via the Barry Way. Now we're heading for Omeo, so we'll turn right on the Snowy River Road, which starts out gravel, goes to a little bit of sealed again, and back to gravel, and then we'll turn a left on Limestone Road. Turning on Limestone Road, you're greeted with a sign suggesting 70 kilometres of twisties, but Limestone Road is a very nice riding gravel road which winds over the mountains, and it's just another one of those great rides. Pretty wide and very interesting, definitely worthwhile riding to Omeo via Limestone Road. Limestone Road is another easy riding gravel road. Its main features were it's very dusty, it was undulating and had quite a lot of windy parts over mountain rises. I remember saying while we're riding this road that if they sealed it, you wouldn't be able to keep the bikes away from it, but it certainly on the GPS looked like a snake, and we passed a couple of cars, but not many on the entire road. That was one of maybe 2 or 3 cars for the entire road. Limestone Road eventually takes you into Bonang, where we stopped at the general store and had a cold drink and a long chat with the lovely lady in the shop, who seems to work there many hours a day. And she gave us lots of details about Bonang and how we should stay at the Bonang Hotel next time. The 20 kilometre Bonang Road back to Omeo is a really good and recommended ride. But when we went through Omeo and did a little bit of sightseeing, we visited the 1923 built Memorial Bridge and the Oriental Claims Historic Area before heading back to the Golden Age Hotel.